Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. It's been a while since the last Shudao video. So today, we will talk about an advanced Shudao topic. But first, let's get high on tea. This week, I'd like to introduce a green tea growing Taishan or Tai Mountain area. Tai Mountain has a great deal of historical and cultural significance in China. It's located in Tai'an City, Shandong Province. This mountain has been a place of worship for at least 3,000 years now and had served as one of the most important ceremonial centers of China for large portions of its history. There are many great temples located on this mountain, and I have visited many of them. It is a great site for viewing the sunrise. Well, you may naturally assume such a beautiful mountain to produce some great tea. That actually was not the case before 1965. In 1965, the Shandong government started growing tea trees transplanted from the south of China. Historically, the weather and the soil conditions in northern China have not been suitable for growing tea trees. In order to change the situation, the Shandong government invested a lot of resources to cultivate tea trees native to the south of China. After decades of experimentation and hard work, the Taishan area has now been successfully producing more than 30 different types of teas. When I first received Tai Mountain tea about 15 years ago, I did not pay any attention to it since I was unaware that Shandong, being in the north of China, produced any good tea. However, when I drank it, I was impressed by its delicious taste. The green tea from the Tai Mountain region has a very strong, refreshing taste. The difference in weather and soil conditions in Shandong compared to tea growing regions in the south imparts Shandong tea a nice, unique flavor. Most of the tea produced in the Tai Mountain region is green tea. I have a few types of Tai Mountain tea, such as this one. The name of this tea is Junzi Cha, or Gentleman's Tea. To brew Tai Mountain tea, the water temperature should be 90 degrees Celsius. Normally, the water temperature for green tea is about 85 degrees Celsius. But since tea produced in Tai Mountain is a bit stronger in terms of the leaf texture and the taste, water at 90 degrees Celsius is ideal if you want to extract the unique flavor out of the tea leaf. I experimented a lot with this tea using water at different temperatures, and I found water at 90 degrees Celsius to be optimal for brewing this tea. Tai Mountain received a lot of sunshine, resulting in Tai Mountain tea being nutritious. Tai Mountain tea is high in antioxidant and hence great for health. As a result, this tea is becoming increasingly popular in China. Increasing popularity also implies increasing prices, so get it while it's cheap. The color of the decoction is light yellow and can be a bit darker depending on the quantity of tea leaves added to the water. This is what the brewed tea and the tea leaves look like. Let me know in the comments if you have tried Thai Mountain Tea or what tea you are enjoying this week. Not that famous yet, but the flavor is great. Now let's get on with today's topic. I have posted 14 Xiudao videos covering some basic concepts of Xiudao, along with the systematic introduction of many critical terms and clarifications of some misperceptions. This step-by-step approach will gradually deepen your understanding of Xiudao. In today's video, I will introduce an advanced topic, Lian Shen Huan Xu. It is an abstract but very important topic. I strongly recommend you watch my prior Xiudao videos to make this video easier to process. Link to my Xiudao playlist is in the description. Topics covered in today's video include: first, Xu in Daoism; second, Lian Shen Huan Xu; third, practice of Lian Shen Huan Xu; fourth, principle of Lian Shen Huan Xu; fifth, practice time; sixth, takeaways. So, without any further ado, let's get started. First, Xu in Daoism. In Daoism, Xu or emptiness is the shorter version of Tai Xu. So, in order to understand the term Xu, you first need to understand the term Tai Xu, or else you will only achieve a superficial understanding of this key Taoist concept. The term Tai Xu consists of two characters. Tai means great. In ancient China, Tai was very often used in philosophical terms to express the quality of greatness. The word Xu means emptiness. Put together, Tai Xu has multiple meanings depending on the context. Tai Xu has three common meanings in the context of Daoism. Let me introduce them one by one. First, Tai Xu means universe. For example, in ancient China, some philosophers believed Tai Xu Ji Qi, or the universe is just energy. Second, Tai Xu means the origin of the universe. Hence, Tai Xu is a philosophical term used to describe the nature of the universe or energy. Third, Tai Xu means Tao, so Tai Xu is Tao. Even though Xiudao may use the term Tai Xu in multiple ways, it normally means the origin of the universe. Ancient Chinese explained Tai Xu and Qi or energy differently. For example, some philosophers such as Zhang Zai in the Song Dynasty believed that the universe or Tai Xu could not exist without Qi, or Tai Xu is just Qi. Also, Tai Xu is the original state of Qi, or the state before Qi gathers together. Furthermore, energy in Tai Xu gathers together and we call it Qi. Well, Qi can convert to living entities, including humans. So, our human nature is just Qi. The different properties of Qi determines the character of each individual. An individual can improve the righteous qi through de or virtue. This part goes beyond the concept of xu or tai xu in the Xiudao context. I will talk more about it in the future. To summarize, xu or tai xu is an ancient Chinese philosophical term used to describe the origin of the universe, which is closely related to human nature. Then, what is Lian Shen Huan Xu? That brings us to the next topic. Topic 2, 练神还虚。In prior videos, I have briefly introduced 炼精化气、炼气化神 and 炼神还虚。Translation: refine the essence to energy, refine the energy to spirit, and refine the spirit to emptiness. End translation. I have also mentioned that 炼精化气 or refine the essence to energy.Is the objective of 小周天 or small orbit practice. 炼气化神 or refined energy to spirit is the objective of 大周天 or large orbit practice. It is quite easy to understand 小周天 and 大周天. But then, what is 炼神还虚 or refined spirit to emptiness?In other words, what is the practice of emptiness? This is the key question to be answered in today's video. 炼神还虚 is also called 上关 or upper gates. It is an advanced stage of 修道 practice compared to the previous two stages, small and large orbit practices. In other words,Small and large orbit practices are prerequisite for achieving the ideal benefit of the next stage, 炼神还虚. Taoism emphasizes 无为 or non-action. However, 无为 is an overall guiding principle in practice. In other words, at any specific stage,You need specific practices to achieve 无为. In a prior video, I have also introduced another Taoist term, 无为有法 or non-action but with method. So, the stage of refining the essence into energy or the first stage of 修道 practice, being the stage to build a strong foundation,requires practitioners to focus on method. Sometimes, people also call this stage 有为 or with action stage. Next comes the second stage of 修道 practice, or 炼气化神. It is called middle level practice, or 中关 or middle gate. At this stage,The guiding principle becomes 有无之交 or mixed stage of with action and non-action. A specific stage that lies between with action and non-action. Finally, we get to the upper gate or 上关, a stage of complete non-action. A stage that is elevated from physical to spiritual,from immortal practice to practice of the Tao, and beyond. Ancient 修道 practice emphasized 上观 as a step to cultivate 阳神 or 阳 spirit, which would reveal the many functions of Tao through practice. Since the stage needs long-term practice, it is called九年关 or 9-year gate, meaning that it takes 9 years of practice. By the way, the number 9 here does not literally mean the exact number 9 at all. It is a rather symbolic expression of the necessity of long-term practice. In Taoism, for example, according to 五柳派 or Wu Liu School of 修道. The energy body should not stay at the lower Dan Tian after it becomes strong enough. Instead, it should move up to the upper Dan Tian and nourish it in the Ni Wan Gong or Ni Wan Palace. Then, it will go beyond the physical body and merge with the Tai Xu or Great Emptiness.In other words, at this stage, the spirit can move out of the upper dantian and merge with the great abdomen. Or it can also stay in the upper dantian and get nourished further. So, understanding the term 炼神还虚, especially correctly understanding the nature of emptiness, is the key factor to practicing refining the spirit to emptiness, or refining the spirit so that it will return to the great emptiness. This is the nature of the universe, which includes both our body and the space beyond our body. With regard to the advanced level of this stage, Wu Chongxu, one of the most important Xiudao scholars of his time, said, quote, 炼神者无神可宁之谓也。原手中哺乳时尚有寂照之神，此后神不自神，复归无极，体证虚空。 End quote. Translation. To refine the spirit, it is the stage without focusing on spirit. When cultivating the energy body through 手中 or focusing on the middle, there is a spirit used to observe the energy. However, at that stage, the spirit is not the same spirit anymore and it returns to the non-polarization stage of 无极 and reveals the truth of emptiness. End translation. In the interest of time and simplicity, I will elaborate further on this topic in the future. Now, let's look at how to practice 炼神还虚 in the next topic. Topic 3. Practice of 炼神还虚. Different styles of 修道 practice that stage differently. I will introduce the most popular practice used in that stage. First, you should strengthen and nourish your spirit. To reach the 炼神还虚 stage, not only should you nourish the energy in the Ni Wan Gong or Ni Wan Palace, but more importantly, this energy has to merge with the middle and the lower dantian as one. Also, you should always apply the concept of non-action, which means to keep the energy as it exists, but focus on it as it does not exist. Do not forget these sentences, and it reveals the spirit of the real focus. In the next step, the functions of the spirit will be strengthened. Also, more and more spiritual experiences will happen. Every practice at this stage should be very careful. I will elaborate on the details in future videos. 还虚, or returning to the emptiness, is the ultimate goal of this step in terms of practice. To merge with the emptiness, you should not focus on emptiness either, since there is still the separation between oneself and the emptiness when focusing on emptiness. Again, think about it. You will notice things become further abstract now. If you recall what I have introduced in the Da Zhou Tian or Large Orbit introduction video in terms of energetic experiences of that stage, similar experiences may happen at that stage, but in a much more harmonious manner. When the spirit is approaching the emptiness, it is different from what potentially happens in the Da Zhou Tian stage. So, if some energetic experiences happen, then just let them be. Now, let's talk about a couple of important principles related to 炼神还虚, which can help you understand this topic better. Topic 4. Principles of 练神还虚。A very abstract concept without sufficient elaboration can often end up misleading practitioners. Introducing some important principles is one of the effective ways of elaborating on a concept and will improve your understanding of the said concept. Let me introduce three important principles of 练神还虚 in today's video.First, 练神还虚 practice built upon a long-term practice of a previous stage. Any practice without a strong foundation of previous stages will not only lead to suboptimal result, but more importantly, may also lead to unnecessary energy deviation. Bear in mind, at this stage, you should focus on the spirit,or the advanced level of energy refinement practice, which can very easily go wrong, especially when you practice without a qualified teacher. If it's any consolation, most practitioners usually cannot reach this level, thus minimizing any chances of a potential harm due to incorrect practice. Second, once you reachThis level, even though there are many spiritual energy experiences that emerge at this stage, including both inward and outward activities, you should continue to remain more inward than outward. As for the inward and outward activities,It is a very profound topic in Taoism and very often can lead to misunderstanding. But I hope you still remember these principles when you reach this level. Last but not least, do not misunderstand the word focus. It is very hard to find a suitable word here to accurately express the meaning of focus.In the context of non-action, if we have to use the word focus, a close enough expression would be non-action focus. In other words, you should let the spirit handle itself in the primordial stage. It is important that you don't actively anticipate any experience. Let the experiences happen.Don't stress on them. Again, emptiness should be merged with our spirit or else it won't be considered Tai Xu or the Great Emptiness. Now, let's move on to the simple exercise for Upper Dantian practice. Topic 5. Practice time. Today, I'd like to introduce a simple preparatory exercise that involvesUpper Dantian practice. Choose a quiet place and sit in a comfortable posture. Again, crossing legs is not necessary here. Then close your eyes and breathe naturally. Focus on the lower Dantian. Then move your attention to Upper Dantian while your hands are makingOpening and closing movement slowly at the forehead level. Keep in mind that you have to relax your facial muscles. Repeat this movement as many times as you want. Then move your attention down to the lower Dantian again and keep your mind here. Hands stop the previous movement and keep them on the stomach.Keep this posture as long as you want. Eventually, open your eyes. Topic 6. Takeaways. First, Xu or Xu Dao is an ancient Chinese philosophical term used to describe the origin of the universe, which is closely related to our human nature. Second, 练神还虚, also called Shang Guan or Upper Gate, is an advanced stage of Xiu-Dao practice compared to the previous two stages, small and large orbit practices. Third, different styles of Xiu-Dao practice this stage differently. In this video, I have introduced the most popular practice used in this stage. Fourth, principles of Lian Shen Huan Xu. First, Lian Shen Huan Xu builds upon long-term practice of previous stages. Second, upon reaching this stage, your focus should remain more inward than outward. Third, your focus should be a rather passive focus, which will allow the spirit to handle itself in the primordial stage. Fifth, remember to check out the practice time section for a simple preparatory upper dantian practice exercise. That concludes today's video. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and enjoy your practice.